Hello and welcome to this course on numerical methods. In the previous lecture, we saw an example of an iterative method. The iterative method was to find square root of 2. In this lecture, we will take an example of a direct method. And the direct method that we are going to use is to use the Maclaurin series in order to find e to the power x. Now, what is the Maclaurin series for e to the power x? The Maclaurin series is given over here. Okay, e to the power x is equal to 1 plus x plus x square by 2 factorial plus x to the power 3 by 3 factorial, so on and so forth. What we are going to do is we will use this Maclaurin series to find exponent e to the power, let us say 0.5. Okay? So, what we will do is we will keep including more and more terms in the Maclaurin series and see what we are going to get. Okay? So, let us call this term number, okay, the term, value and approximate value of e to the power x. So, let us look at this. The 0th order term is just this guy, that term is 1, the value is 1, approximate value of e to the power x with this is equal to 1. The first order term, let us second order term, third order term, fourth order term, and let us say fifth order term. Okay? So, the first order term is x. The second order term is x square by 2 factorial, third order term is x cube by 3 factorial, x to the power 4 by 4 factorial, and then x to the power 5 by 5 factorial. Okay? We will keep finding those values and keep adding it to the previous guess. Okay? So, x is nothing but 0.5. Okay. So, the approximate value of e to the power x is 1 plus 0.5, that is 1.5. Okay. Now, what is going to be x square divided by 2? X square divided by 2 is going to be nothing but 0.5 square divided by 2 equal to 0.125. Okay? We will add that 0.125 to 1.5 plus 1.5 equal to, so 1.625 is the guess and 0.125 comes over here. Okay? Now, the next term, which is x cube divided by 3 factorial. Okay? This is where I will introduce a new concept. That new concept is that do not compute x to the power 3 divided by 3 factorial as a division of two very large numbers. So, for example, if you have x to the power 10 by 10 factorial, here x is 0.5, so this won't be a problem. But if let us say you wanted to find exponent of say 5, you will have to compute 5 to the power 10 and then you will have to compute 10 factorial and then you will have to divide those two numbers. Division or subtraction of two very large numbers usually is to be avoided, and that is because of round of errors. We have talked about round of errors earlier in this module. Okay? So, instead what you should do is x cube divided by 3 factorial is nothing but x square by 2 factorial multiplied by x by 3. Okay? So, x cube by 3 factorial is nothing but 0.125 multiplied by x by 3, and that is what we are going to do. So, we have 0.125 multiplied by x divided by 3. That is the next term, and that is 0.02083. let us add 1.625 and we will get 1.64583. Sorry, 1.64583. Okay. Now, what is going to be x to the power 4 by 4 factorial is nothing but 3 by 3 factorial multiplied by x by 4. Okay. That is what the next term is going to be. So, it is 0.0283 okay, multiplied by 0.5 divided by 4. Okay. That is 0.002604. Okay, let us add that to 1.64583 and we are going to get 1.64843. Okay. The next guy is going to be x to the power 4 by 4 factorial multiplied by x by 5, okay, which is going to be 0.002604 multiplied by 0.5 divided by 5. That is going to be 0.00026. Okay, and if we add plus 1.64843, that is going to be 1.64869. Okay, and this is our approximate value of e to the power 0.5. at calculated using 5 terms of or up using the 5th order term of the Maclaurin series. Let us compare it with the true value, and for to compare with the true value we will have 0.5, okay, 1.64869, and the true value is 1.64872. So, minus 1.64869 is going to be equal to 3.127 into 10 to the power minus 5, and that for a 5 significant digit arithmetic, that is a reasonable accuracy, and so it is a good idea that for us to stop at 5th order term in the Maclaurin series. So, this is how you will use a Maclaurin series in order to calculate approximate value of e to the power x. Unlike the previous lecture, we are not iterating on anything, we are simply adding additional terms in the Maclaurin series, and therefore, this is not an iterative method, this is a direct method. So, for example, if you had to calculate e to the power x to the up to 5 terms, okay, all you need to do is you can do 1 plus x plus x square by 2 plus x cube by 6 plus x to the power 4 by 24 plus x to the power 5 by 120, and you can directly calculate this using a calculator or a computer and you will get the final answer. That is the reason why it is called a direct method. as against that in the iterative method you had an initial guess of square root of 2 and you kept improving that initial guess as you did more and more iterations. So, that is the difference between iterative method and the direct method. In today's lecture, we have covered the direct method for calculating e to the power x to the accuracy of 4 significant digits. Thank you very much and I will see you in the next lecture. Bye.